Hello, friends. Quick update today because things are happening and I thought it was time to share. So thank you for joining me here. Those of you are new to YouTube, where I upload these as well, so go check it out. I'm Heather Lambert, triple negative breast cancer, diagnosed March 2022, so long ago. I've done everything, all the things. Chemotherapy, surgery, radiation, more chemotherapy, immunotherapy, all the things. So that's my first thing to tell you is I'm done with treatment. So weird. I don't think it's really set in yet, to be honest. But yeah, I finished my last treatments just a couple of weeks ago. And that's it. I'm done. So they say, not really, but yes, active treatment is finished. No more chemotherapy, no more immunotherapy, no more radiation. All of it's finished. So from here we monitor and I recover. And that's pretty much the plan. So, building my strength back, building my endurance back, healing my body, all those kinds of things. So, very exciting. Active treatment is finished. Okay, so number two, when I finished active treatment, I have had for a very long time on my calendar a plan to go on a trip. Those of you that know, I am a Scentsy consultant. I have had my Scentsy business for more than 12 years. And every year we have a convention in the summertime. It's in a different city every year. So this year we were in Charlotte, North Carolina. And it just happened to be scheduled 2 weeks after my last chemotherapy. So I said, I am going. I don't even care. I'm going to my convention. I missed last year because of chemo. This year I was not missing. So I went to Charlotte with ideas of celebrating and having just the best time. And I did have absolutely the best time. But it was not exactly the way I'd expected. it seems when you've finished a year and a half of cancer treatment, your body is not quite up to par. It's not quite up to normal standards. So just walking around on travel day, airports to hotels and all of that sort of thing, I was completely wiped out. Felt better after a good night's sleep, but the next day, just the conference hadn't even started yet. Just walking around getting my bearings and checking in and getting registered and all that kind of stuff, I was toast. My body hurt. I was exhausted. I could not go. So I had the most wonderful roommates. And they went down to the front desk and got me a wheelchair and they pushed me around the convention center back and forth to the hotel 100 times all week long for our convention and saved me. I would not have made it through that week without them. Because just being able to conserve my energy from all of the extra walking and back and forths, I was able to save it and do the things I needed to do. And the things I needed to do were very important. So it also turns out that while I was on that trip, I was fighting an infection. So a little UTI had started before I left. And so as I drained my body of everything I had, that grew to a little bit more than just a little UTI, became more of like a kidney infection, bladder kidney infection. So I hobbled through the week, a lot more worse off than I should have been. But if those girls had not pushed me around, I probably would have ended up in an ambulance at an emergency room, I'm pretty sure. But made it home on Sunday and got to the urgent care and got me some antibiotics. And I am feeling so much better, much more like myself. But I still have realized that I have to go slow and I have to pace myself. I have to save my energy for what I need it for, and I have to recover if I use it. I am not as strong as I used to be, and I have to build that strength back, and it's going to take time. And so this trip has taught me that, that when you're done chemo and cancer treatment, whatever treatment, it's not over. there's still a recovery period that's going to take quite a while to get back to normal, right? So people think, oh, you're not getting chemo anymore, you're fine. Like, no, my body is trashed. So that will take some time, but we'll get there. We will get there. The other cool thing I got to do while I was at my convention was I was asked to share my story on stage for the entire convention. We're talking like 6,000 people plus. And it was absolutely amazing to be able to share my story, just a little piece of my story. I only got 10 minutes, but to be able to share a piece of my story and to inspire other people to push through hard times and challenges, and know that they can get through and that they are not alone going through challenges, especially breast cancer, which they're, you know, in a direct sale company, there are thousands, they're mostly women, right? So there are probably hundreds of breast cancer survivors in the audience. So it was really, really cool to be able to be on stage and share my story with all of them. And what I shared was that most of the support that I got, particularly in the beginning, like my family and whatnot took care of me. But in the beginning when I was diagnosed and everything was scary and unsure and you're just not sure what to expect, it was my Sensi family people that had been through cancer before that scooped me up and got me through all of that. They were the support. They were the proof that I could get through this because they had gotten through it. And so in reaching out to them and becoming close with so many of them that were going through it with me, we became really, really important to each other. And that support for each other was really, really special and really important. And so being able to share that on stage and then giving hope to those that were going through it on their own maybe and didn't know there were others out there, and for them to realize that our Sensi family is such a close-knit support group for each other, allowed them to share their stories and connect to us. And so we have this huge group now of survivors within our Sensi community, our Sensi family, supporting each other and helping each other, whether they're currently going through treatment or whether it's been years, because even like years down the road, you still have things that pop up and times that get triggering and scary. So just to have everybody and know that you're not alone is so, so important. And so I was so, so grateful to be able to share my story on stage like that and be able to talk to so many people after who said how inspiring and how grateful they were that I had shared. So that was really cool. So want to come be part of our Sensi family? Just message me. We can make that happen. It's really, really special to be part of a group and an organization that cares so much about each other. So anyway, so that was really, really special. But I made it home. And I am here and I'm feeling so much better and I'm looking forward to what's coming next. I do have a fun thing coming next that I will share soon. Not quite yet, but I will share soon. But the earlier this week, I guess it was Monday, I had a PET scan. So now that I'm done treatment, I wanted to do a scan just to confirm that everything has gone away. And it gives us a good baseline. So if I ever need a scan in the future, we have something to compare to. So I had PET scan and I believe things are good. I will have official conversation with my doctor in a week or so. And then I got my surgery date. So August 17th, I will go in and have my exchange surgery. So back in November, I had a double mastectomy. Both boobies gone, and then they put in the expanders. So they're temporary implants that kind of hold the space so that I could go through radiation without damaging the implants. So I've had those for 9-10 months now. They're not the most comfortable things in the world. They're not the most attractive, but they did their job and they held the space. But I'm very, very excited to get them out and to have the actual implant, which will be much more natural, looking, feeling much softer, much more comfortable. I'm just super excited. Super excited. So August 17th, I will go have my expanders removed. I will have my port removed, this baby that has been with me the whole time and I'm so grateful for. I will get that removed and then I will have my permanent implants put in. And that's it. That's the end, guys. I get blood work every 3 months and I'll check in with my oncologist for a couple of years just to make sure things stay the way they're supposed to. But that's it. Done. A year and a half later. It's a little surreal. I look back and I can't believe how much we've done, and how much we've gone through, and it's just over. It's really weird. It's really weird. But I'll figure it out, I promise. Life goes on. Bigger and better things. So many exciting things to look forward to. We have a busy Scentsy season coming up. I have some other fun things. Some more speaking engagements, I hope. I have some fun activities with my support groups here locally coming up. Breast Cancer Awareness Month is coming in October. It's right around the corner. Scentsy's got an amazing cause collection for breast cancer coming out in October. I can't wait to share that with you when it comes. Just exciting things happening all around. So yeah, fun. I guess that's it for now. I will update again soon. Fun announcements coming. Things are happening. But I hope you guys are all doing well. I hope that you are having a fabulous August. And we'll talk again soon. Bye for now.